Recount Thursday is sponsored by Arena Eats. Log on to the website arenaeats.app, that's arenaeats.app, for the ultimate fan experience. At your favorite sports venue, Arena Eats mobile app, pre-order, express pickup, and in-seat delivery. How do you place your order? We have
the three count question of the week.
Because we are starting a new year. And I thought, you know, we always look back on who had a great year and, you know, who was the best and what was the best match. So why don't we sit here at the start of the year and we'll go with both WWE and AEW. They're, you know, generally observed as the two biggest dogs in the game. And what superstar should get the biggest push? Now, if you want to name a male and female, or if you just want to name, you know, one or the other, that's up to you guys. And does anybody want to start the discussion? Matt, go ahead.
Goldberg and Sting.
No. I said what superstars should get the biggest push, not which superstars will get the biggest push.
My
apologies. Well, for that, you start us anyway.
For should get the biggest push, in my opinion, in WWE, it is Shotzi Blackheart. I think that the women's division needs some new blood. I think her going to the main roster would be a huge, huge get for them. Despite that would make NXT's women's roster suffer a bit, I think WWE roster needs it more. So she would be my vote for WWE.
Go ahead.
AEW. I don't know. I don't really watch it. Is Luke Perry's kid still there?
Jungle Jack Perry.
Jack Perry, huh? Right. Yeah, he's still there. Actually,
so speaking of him, Tony Khan's throwing around more money. He apparently paid for the rights for Jungle Boy, or what's the name of that song? Is it
Jungle Love?
Boogie.
Tarzan Kid. Tarzan.
Yeah, Tarzan Boy.
Tarzan Boy. To be Jungle Boy's theme.
Tarzan nice. Boy. Oh, okay. I got you. I got you. All right.
That's the name of the song, I think, is Tarzan Boy.
I believe so.
I feel like you should have popped for George of the Jungle's theme.
Oh, that would have been good, too.
Watch out for that. Ah, ooh, Luchasaurus.
Could have worked.
That could have worked. Anybody want to go next?
I can go next.
Okay, go ahead. Don't sound so excited, Ryan.
You're twisting my leg.
Okay.
Oh, boy. Here's
Eeyore.
The WWE, the biggest push in 2021, absolutely should be Big E Langston, better known as Big E. I think it is long overdue that we push another member of the New Day. We broke him apart, and you might as well do it. I think we've started to see it with his Intercontinental Championship reign. And for AEW, literally any woman you want to pick on the roster should be pushed. any woman. Pick one.
Maybe
that's the one you should push.
Maybe except Abaddon.
Don't even give a shit. Put all their names in a hat and just
pick one. Oh, you mean like they did for their tag team tournament?
That's how they should do
That's how they should do it. Okay. Tim, how about you?
Sure. So for me, I'm not going to take this. One of my answers has already been taken, so I'm changing. I'm flipping the script. I'm going to go with, oh God.
Which one was taken?
Oh, Big E, obviously.
Oh, okay.
Like Big E is absolutely the slam dunk.
Tim, no one said Damian Priest. You can still pick him.
There's no
he's
way.
He's on the board.
He's going to live on the board if I have anything to say about it. God, now I have to dig through and find one.
Should I move to Mark?
No, okay. No, I'll get there.
I can change mine to somebody like Cesaro.
No,
if you want. Okay.
No, right. No. No. This is kind of a cheap answer. I'm ready.
You might as well let the song play out.
Okay.
R.I.P. Alex Trebek.
It's a cheap answer because he's always kind of on the cusp of getting pushed.
John Cena?
But I'm going with The Miz.
Okay.
The Miz need in 2021, The Miz needs the full ascension into main event status. They need to just hurry up, get over it. He's got Money in the Bank again. Now's your chance. This is
right,
the opportunity.
Like, do
this
it.
This is the vehicle. Shove him up there.
Just and do it.
And then keep him there. It's not that hard.
Right.
Just keep him.
Well, there. For WWE, sometimes it is.
No, it's not.
I heard you say ascension. Are you bringing in the return as well into your
no,
answer?
No. Oh, no.
Yeah, that's the next question.
And then as for All Elite Wrestling, again, this is like the one answer that I will always go to for AEW is Scorpio Sky.
Love it.
There's no reason why Darby Allin's going against Taz's Maniacs for the TNT Championship, which, by the way, the redesign of that title is smooth as silk.
Infinitely better than, yeah.
Red strap. The black strap is a nice touch. But Scorpio Sky, to me, he's can't miss. He's a blue chipper. All the adjectives you want to give him, that's the guy in 2021. He was the guy in 2020. You gave him to us. You took him away from us. You started to give him back to us. You took him away. Just hurry up and just do it already.
I don't know if anybody saw the comment from Charlie here, but can we elaborate? I have no idea what that is.
What is it? I didn't hear it.
If anyone hasn't, I highly recommend Wrestle Kingdom. What is that?
Oh, so in Japan, they wrestle the other way. So you know how, like, how here when you watch wrestling, they go around the ring one way.
Uh-huh.
But then when you go the other side of the world, it goes the other. That's toilets.
Oh, yeah. It's
What the hell is even that?
I don't know. No, I'm kidding. No, I heard rest.
I heard good things.
Night two. I heard night two was better than night one.
Naito, that's one of the wrestlers, right?
No, wait, they do two nights of that? They're copying off of WrestleMania?
Naito.
No, they actually did it first.
I like how on the 10-year anniversary of Miz's main event at Mania, Tim wants to give him another push. Let's do Miz versus Cena again at this WrestleMania. Like every 10 years.
But both of them are better now than they were then. That's
a
great match.
But make it like the
wait, so are we going to get a Miz cash in and then Cena's going to win 17 over the Miz 10 years after the fact?
The are Miz we talking about Miz's opponents at WrestleManias?
No, we're not. We're talking about who's going to get the biggest push in 2021.
My bad.
Okay. That's who we're talking about. I mean, we do sway from topic to topic. So, intern Mark.
I'm going to finish the job that other guy started on Twitter on Tuesday if you keep this up.
Three Count Thursday is sponsored by Arena Eats. Log on to the website arenaeats.app, that's arenaeats.app, for the ultimate fan experience. At your favorite sports venue, Arena Eats mobile app, pre-order, express pickup, and in-seat delivery. How do you place your order? Intern Mark, who should get the biggest push this year?
Was somebody pissed at me on Twitter?
No, not you.
He was talking to me.
The guy who's got the board.
Man. Let's see. Biggest push.
I'm not saying shit.
What happened, Smokey?
He can't say
it. Yeah.
got a reminder up here so I don't say it.
Oh, you really aren't saying shit.
Oh, come on.
We're smoking. Are we talking about the biggest return of the year?
No, no. We'll get to return. This is the biggest push of the year.
Okay. Biggest push of the year. Let's see. Some of the answers I was going to go to have been taken, so I'm not going to repeat any. But Smokey did mention Cesaro, and that's who I was thinking of. But even before he said that, but
I like it.
Wouldn't the Cesaro and Roman Reigns, wouldn't that be a great feud?
Yeah.
And I would like that a lot. And Cesaro is he's beyond ready. It's about time. That would be really nice. My other guess would have been Keith Lee, but I think he's still a little – he's got a little time yet, so I'm going to go with Cesaro for the male. AEW looks pretty obvious, like it's going to be Darby Allin, especially getting that rub from Sting. And if I had to do female, I mean, I really like Shotzi Blackheart, but I'll go with Rhea Ripley. I think she's going to do something. Rumored to be coming up to the main roster. And yeah. AEW female, boy, really any of them. So I'm going to go with, how about Jordynne Grace? I'm going to go Jordynne Grace. I think she'll be making an appearance.
She's in AEW. Well, yeah, I mean, I guess Impact and those lines are blurred. So why the hell not? I like that.
Yeah, I think it's going to happen.
For me, in WWE, I mean, a lot of the ones already mentioned, you know, I think are great. I'm gonna go with a female here, and it's something that I feel like they've kind of been building with vignettes, but just go with it as fast and as hard as you can is Bianca Belair. I mean, she's incredible. I mean, like no one else in the women's division right now, and she has star written all over her. So by all means, figure out a way to get her in the title picture, winning the title and having a good run with the title. In AEW, I gotta go Eddie Kingston. Like, I mean, this is a guy that if you would have told me a year ago was going to be in AEW, I don't necessarily think I would have believed you, and not because he's not good enough, but I didn't feel like he was on that radar. But I mean, over the last 6 months, I mean, his faction, his promos, I mean, everything has just been pure gold. And I mean, he's older, correct? I mean, I don't know the Eddie Kingston history, but he's 41, something like that. He's in his 40s, isn't he?
Believe so.
39.
Okay, so like
the wrong side of 30.
He is on the wrong side of 30.
Can't
so
say that anymore.
Oh, I will.
Jim, are you going to start calling him Oldie Kingston now? Or?
Well, no. I think you have to hit 50 before I start really calling you old. Yeah, give me an Eddie Kingston push and title run sometime in 2021, please. And it doesn't even necessarily have to be the AEW World Championship, although I think it would be great. But even if he gets a good run with the TNT title, just feature him more. I think would be great. Is there any, before we move to the next one, is there any others that you would like to see more featured this year in either company?
None that don't match or meet the qualifications of our next topic.
Okay.
I would like to see a little bit more out of Kyle O'Reilly, maybe, in NXT. I think we're getting it already.
Okay.
I still think he's probably the best wrestler of the group.
I would agree with that.
So I just, more of him's fine. Kobe.
Yeah, I certainly agree. Yeah, I mean, there's nobody that necessarily jumped. I mean, like Keith Lee, I feel like it's hard to say he should be pushed more when he just had an absolute banger of a WWE championship match on the first Raw of 2021.
There was a moment I thought my bold prediction was going to be ruined.
I did too, Ryan. And I mean, like, that match is the first match on my list of matches for 2021. I thought it was a fantastic title match that we got for free, as people like to point out sometimes.
Six stars in Japan.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, but I mean, more of Keith Lee. Like, I don't want him to have this high bar at the start of the year and then just, and then we never really hear of him again. And I don't think that's going to be the case, especially when you go out and deliver a match like that. So, anything else, we'll jump to the next.
I mean, there are some, I guess we could keep, I don't know. Adam Page, I believe it should be on everybody's list.
Absolutely.
In 2021, yeah. That should be there. And I think, Jim, you were even tweeting about it. When Wardlow finally turns on MJF, I think that'll be a big face push that everybody will want to be behind.
Yes. Yeah. I think I said that the other week. Yeah.
And that'll be something that's not necessarily started yet, but they might have just lit the fire a little bit.
There's been a few points, I think, before Wardlow and MJF went into the inner circle. I think there was some kind of hints that could be coming, and now that they're in the inner circle, everything seems, and that's cool. Like, I mean, you think back to the Mega Powers. I mean, that was a story that was, you know, you saw the first kind of inklings of it and breakups and things like that, and then you wouldn't really know about it for a couple months at a time. And I get wrestling's a lot different now because we're inundated with it week after week after week, but slow burns are great. I think you're gonna have a slow, you know, and I think I even tweeted on Raw this Monday was when The Miz turns on Morrison, or as some people suggested, Morrison turns on The Miz. You know, when, like, if Morrison, because I assume it'll be Miz berating Morrison and Morrison could snap, and then either way, Miz will be the heel, Morrison will be the face. But when that split happens, I think it'll be good for both parties as well. Three Count Thursday is sponsored by Arena Eats. Log on to the website arenaeats.app, that's arenaeats.app, for the ultimate fan experience. At your favorite sports venue, Arena Eats mobile app, pre-order, express pickup, and in-seat delivery. How do you place your order?